Hello. Hi. It's ordity and we're getting the feedback thing today. We were listening to this track, to this album. How's everybody doing? The first track we got from the Amaraf Todd. So yeah, let's see. Okay, so first of all, I think this track is really nice already in the shape that it is in right now. Need to listen to it again because I didn't like pick up anything specific other than like, for example, here at the end there is this one frequency. just gets a bit. Yeah, that one specific frequency that the resonance gets too loud at one point. And I think that could be like just an EQ, or even better if it was like a dynamic EQ, but that's maybe an overkill, like just a little bit of a dip in there. Oh, it's going to get redone. Yeah, so like that's just something that I'd keep in mind for the future, to just keep track of if there isn't like a specific frequency or specific resonance that gets too loud. Now let me listen to it again and see if anything pops up more, anything more specific pops up. Like you mentioned that side chaining you're gonna redo as well, because I feel like not every element in this needs to be side not every element in this needs to be sidechained, I think. Like the more high frequency part thing, the like the keys in this don't really need to be sidechained very much. Yeah, I think they could go without even a sidechain, or maybe like a very, very slight sidechain in there. Yeah, like that double kick in there, it sidechains as well. So yeah, stuff like that. But you already mentioned that you're already thinking about remaking it. Like, you said that to ignore the bad sidechaining, you'll fix it later. So yeah, that's just like basic stuff. This one had like a little bit of new resonance as well in there. It wasn't like as painful, I think. Just in there. Yeah. Just like a little bit. You could dip it out a little bit, I think. Oh, I only now realized there's like a little up thing from like bells or something in the background. I think there could be like a little part, like even 15 seconds or something, where you bring that up in the focus way more and like make it a bit louder, but that would need a change in structure. And I think the structure already is pretty good. Like this is basically a finished track already. So I'm not sure if you want to do that, just like something that could be cool to see, in my opinion. Other than that, I don't think there's anything really that wrong with it or anything. Or you could like... Yeah. Or you could like make that up thing in the more focused in the outro, I think. That could also work. Because you said you're gonna rewrite the outro anyway. Yeah, like... Instead of all this, where you can hear the compression working really hard on the pad, you could like bring that melodic element, like that little up in here, as an ending. And of course, like, that outro bit also had like a DC offset, very obvious one. So yeah, that could also need fixing if you decide to leave that in. But the, like, it doesn't even need to be fixed because like this isn't like a very commercial based music, of course. It's more like chill music that you just listen to and vibe to. So yeah, that's about it, I think, for this track. Let's listen to it again from the start. So yeah, let's move on to the next one. And the next one is from the server versus server thing, from the group 4. Fuck off. I'm gonna have to download it. See, he's in that group. Ray, Digital Forest, Bask and Stock. So yeah. Okay, so yeah, there's a few suggestions, I guess, like creative feedback that I could give on this. So, like, for example, something that. Because, first of all, this is absolutely amazing, and I think it will work great as an ending to the whole EP. But let me turn up Ableton since I already have it downloaded as a file. Yeah, I know, free trial. Okay. So this is just gonna be easier that way. And work that. So first of all. Avenged, you can absolutely send a remix as a feedback, just like keep in mind that we're usually focusing on more glitchy and IDM oriented things. So if it like fits that aesthetic, then absolutely you can send a remix track for feedback. So that main lead in here. Something I at least I personally would play around with is to like make it detuned more and more as the track progresses, or like start it out as a very detuned thing and then make it less and less detuned. So like for example in Vital, you would like have like I don't know 13 voices. And you would just over the course of the track, you would get it like something like this. Or like even in specific moments, and then bring it up, bring it back to the very undetuned version of it. So like here it would be the most attuned, and like here you would go back to the undertuned version, like very smooth version, if that makes sense. So that's something I would like try to play around, because I think that could like add a lot of tension in this part. And then resolve it here, and it will like make that lead more tonally interesting, if that makes sense. Not that it sounds bad, because it sounds really nice, but it would make it more like even more within the glitch aesthetic, if that makes sense. Intro, I think, will be absolutely redone once my group, as me and the rest of my group, just make some kind of outro. So that one I'm not focusing too much on. Also, I think like this part, specific part in here, could go even without drums at all. Or maybe just like the last 8 bars of that little section with just the up. Like build a little bit of tension before the final part of the track. Yeah, the intro is like the last part that any group will do, I think, other than the first group, because we want to make it all interconnected. So in this part, for some reason, the snare seems a little bit like more, I don't know, low passed or something, where it has like less high end than before. So like it usually stays at around, I don't know, -36 in here. think it's mostly because there's a lot more elements in the top and in here than in here, but it creates this sort of like, I don't know, contrast where this part seems not as bright as the other parts, I think. So I just like add another layer on top of that snare in here. Something to do with like a little bit more crunch or something. Yeah, especially since right before that there's a bit louder thing that is just in the top end in here, so it creates a bit of contrast. Yeah, the ticking clock could work in this way. Yeah, and tying it back to the track one, that could be very cool. So yeah, essentially the detune automation on the lead in here. Maybe try playing around with getting rid of the drums in this part that builds to the last section, and in the last section just add something to add a little bit more brightness to it. And that's about it. Other than that, I think it's like already a really good track. Yeah, let's move on to the next one. Okay, this one is by Ray. Thank you. Okay, so this is really nice. I like this a lot. I'm trying to think if I had anything for the first part. Because for the second, first of all, I think this switch between 4-4 and 7-8 is flawless. Like, you don't even feel that the time signature is changing, because the entire track has changed so much, and that it doesn't matter that it's in 7-8 anymore, because you need to get used to a lot more than just the time signature change, if that makes sense, which is a good thing. I think that works really well in here. I guess something that I would want to see, but it would also, like in one of the previous tracks, it would require a lot of change in how the track is structured and written. It's like the sort of back and forth between the melodic, like keys things, the lead, and the glitches that happen. So like, there's a bit of glitches when the lead thing is happening, but once it like fades out, more and more glitches come in. And then after that, the lead again takes the focus, if that makes sense. There is a little bit of that, but I wish it was like fleshed out more. Like the glitches were fleshed out more. So like, for example, fuck you. For example, here the glitches could like go a little bit faster, or like in slightly different rhythm and stuff like that. Yeah, like if it was a conversation between the melodic parts and the glitchy parts, if that makes sense. Yeah, fine-tuning of the glitches. The sound design is really nice, especially on the glitches and the basses. Yeah, like that little part in there at the end. That like more of that in like in parts where the where it, when the lead already played its little bit, then it's like more elements like that that just play after that, so it feels more natural, sort of like a conversation between those two. Now that's nitpicking, but that little where that hat hits, and there's a lot of low end under
it.
Yeah, like that one. Yeah, I'm not sure if that lower hit is necessary in there. Or maybe like either the hat or the lower hit, I think would work better. But that's a bit of nitpicking already. Yeah. In my opinion, those two together don't work that well in there. Okay, so I think that like little fill in there, I feel like that fill in there, that bass thing, could be like a little bit wider, like a layer on top of that, like just take it, pitch it up by an octave or something, or maybe like a 19 semitones, so it's a third, and just like make it very, very wide with some effects, like wider even or something, and make it like not very like loud, but like just a tiny bit of layer. So it could like tingle your ears, if that makes sense. Just like make it very, not very wide, but like add a lot more stereo information to that part. I think that would work great. And now with the 7/8 part, I think it works really nice, and I like the like back and forth in the rhythmic areas, like the rhythmic elements, a lot of rhythm in there that takes advantage of the fact that it's 7/8. And I think that works well, but something I wish you did more on this part, because it sounds very similar throughout the entire section. I think like something like just background effects or something that just like go up and down, something like in old school dub even artists usually do, like there it is the most prominent thing, where like in the background there's a lot of different effects that lead the entire track. I think you could do a little bit of that in there. Yeah, it's work in progress, of course, so like I'm just giving out different ideas to do stuff with it, to like different directions you could take it. Yeah, a lot of sonic space to fill. Also, I think like every once in a while you could have like the snare hit not have this much reverb, like have it completely dry or something for the contrast. Or like have it pitched up or down every now and then, something like that, like something to just take out the monotony of that snare a bit. Make it a bit more like interesting and stuff. Like making it its own thing instead of like just a thing that happens in the background, if that makes sense. Also something that you will rarely hear from me, but I think it would work better if this part especially, if it was like had some way wider elements, like something that would again tingle your ear, like just sort of coming, or even like panning of those glitchy rhythmic elements, like just pan them around in random order, or even like most basic thing, which is like at least in Ableton be auto pan and not sync but by heads value, so it's like it feels sort of random, if that makes sense. So I think that could work really well in this. Yeah, just like a little bit of like the stereo information. I think that would work great. Other than that, those things like That was a lot of feedback, but I think it's a great start for a track. It's really nice, and I like, and I'm really interested in where this will go. Yeah, I don't usually do panning too much, but I'm trying to, at least recently, I'm trying to get used to it more as well. Yeah, no worries. I feel like most panning is like, I'm very picky with it, so like, I have hard time using panning on anything. Because like, it will never sound good to me unless I spend like, insane amounts of time on it. But I think in here, like, that is something that wouldn't require as much work, I think. I mean, it could be like a lot of work depending on how you go about it, because you could like manually pan each hit differently. But I'm not sure, that would just be insane thing to do, I think. Yeah, ping pong delay can help, but I personally don't like ping pong delay as much in most cases. Especially if it's like total ping pong. Like, it's not just switching this stereo information, but it's like hard panning left and right. Because I feel like there's always one side that's gonna be stronger than the other side. And that's something that at least I personally wouldn't recommend. Auto panning, yeah, that's. I find it easier to use than ping pong delay. So yeah, the next track is from Wireframe Wolves. Let's see. Oh, it's the server versus server again, from group one this time. Some Fool, Renegade, Elden Droid, Wireframe Wolves. Let's see.
Thank you.
Okay, so that was really nice. I like that a lot again. I think all the server versus server tracks are really good so far. So something I would do is like, because you have that like metronome thing as a sort of like clock ticking. I think it would like add a little bit of that effect if you had not only the delay on it that just gets louder, but also a tiny bit of reverb that would imitate the room, if that makes sense. Yeah, I think that would just like be a little bit of effect that you can very easily add. So yeah, that was the first thing. Now, I really like this intro thing and the build up. So obviously if you mix down things, it's like that hit in there. I'm not sure if it's like DC offset or something, but it's like very bassy and there's like a puff on it, and I'm not sure if I like that effect. It sounds like DC just going into saturator, if that makes sense. Yeah, and it happened somewhere in here. In here. Yeah, that hit in there as well. It's even more prominent with that. But I think it's mostly because there's like very little low end before it hits in here. Well, in here you have this sub bass that sort of already fills out that space, so it's not as bad in here as in here, but that's something that in my opinion definitely needs fixing. I really like this part because it's like it's pulling you in and out all the time. Yeah, I think like so I think something that would work in this specific hit in here, where like it hits, something that would like make it even more prominent, the push and pull thing. So this track definitely succeeded in being uncomfortable in the best way possible, of course. Yeah, I think it works best as like introduction to the unsettling dream theme that the first track is supposed to B. I think it's doing a really good job at that. Yeah, something like something in there that would just like pull you out again, because in here you feel like you're falling down, and something that would like make you go up very suddenly, if that makes sense. So something like even a very strong side chain or like some kind of subhead, like very basic thing. Like, let me show what I mean. So something like, something like that. Compression. Not that strong. There's something that would like hit you, if that makes sense. Because it just goes back to normal at that point, and I think you could like flesh out more of that dynamic where it's like going up and down or like pulling you in and out. So like even taking out the sub could work in here, I think. I think that could also, maybe that would even work the best, I think. Just having that do, do, and then go back to all the elements. Like switching between it being full and empty. But yeah, that's something that like you could do to improve that, but I also know that this is the last week of the, I think that's the last week of the server, so there isn't like that much time to change the structure of things. So you could do that, like that I think would be amazing, but there is also limited time, so you gotta think about that. So in this part, there's something wrong to me tonally about the break in the background. Like I wish it was brighter, and I tried to do this before. And yeah, the break then feels like much better to me. But the all the other elements of course sound worse because I'm also like, because the other elements are balanced already really well. So yeah, that would be my thing, just make the break a bit brighter in here. Yeah, that can be fixed during mixing. So yeah, that hit again in here. Could be a lot cleaner, I think. In my opinion, at least, it would work better if it was cleaner. But I didn't like that at first. That you have this very strong build up. And then you go to a very chill kind of drop, but I think like on the second listen it grows on me more. Yeah, I really like that actually. Though another thing is that, like, with those breaks, you could, like, build it up in here with just that break from here. Instead of this separate snare in here that just goes to. Like, instead of that, you could, like, do something that builds up like that with that break, and I think it would work better. Something I'm thinking with that is, like, I can find that there is in one Kerpret song, there is like a bit that I'm thinking of. It was in Yin. It was in this track. There is like, it goes crazy with all those breaks and stuff. And then with toms, it's like building all the time with all the drum hits, and then at the end the tom fill like just indicates that this is the ending and not building up, but it's still like very tense and building the tension, if that makes sense. Yeah, I'm practically always thinking about Deliverance, that's why I bring it up. Yeah, I think you could do like, you could at least try to do something similar in here, where like you have this building of tension, but it goes down, if that makes sense. Or even maybe even like getting rid of that impact in here completely, instead of just fixing it, would work better with that. Because that impact could also, like, I think it also signalizes a bit that something big is coming, and then this part is coming up that is like very chill. Yeah, I think maybe even like getting rid of that up impact sound could work for that. Oh, and here's a third effect like that. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of that sound. It can work in some context, I just don't think it works in here specifically. Yeah, when it comes to writing on this track, I think it's really, really good. And I think this track is amazing already. Let's listen to it again. And if anybody got like any tracks to send to, like, you can always send them to the email address. Because I don't think currently we have anything more. Yeah, that's this one. So yeah, basically this TikTok thing could use a bit of a roomy reverb on it. If you wanna send the track for the feedback, it's in here you send a link or a track to the email address. It's best if it's SoundCloud link, but it doesn't really need to be. Yeah, it's just like the way we do it here in here. Okay, so that was it. Again, like the TikTok thing, the impact thing, those would be like the two main things that at least I personally would love to hear fixed in here. Other than those three. Oh, and the break here should be a lot brighter. But other than that, like, the thing about this and like the building up in here, it's like not really necessary. That's just like things that I personally would do differently. Other than those things, like, this is a really good track, I think. And I'm really excited for all the server versus server things. So yeah, let's see. From Arrow, it's a trap. Okay, let's see. Yeah, no worries.
The longer you live, the more you will realize that the only things that truly exist in this reality are merely pain, suffering, and futility. Listen.
I love you, Hans.
I'm sorry, Arrow, but we mostly do like more experimental music in here. I'm gonna listen to it, but if it's not like super like within the aesthetic, then I think I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to skip this one, sadly.
Relationships that cannot be separated.
Yeah, sadly, this isn't the style of music that we do in here. Well, if you want to get feedback on this, you could hop in the Discord server and ask in there, but like on the stream, we usually focus way more on the IDM and experimental music rather than like more mainstream. Will sound bad because it has bad connotations, but like it just like. It's just not exactly the style of music that we do in here. I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to skip this one. So yeah, other than that, I don't think we have any more tracks right now. Does anybody else have anything to send? In the meantime, we can like listen again to the submission from server versus server. Track 4. Yeah, there doesn't seem to be like many people today. No worries, Ray. Have a nice day. So yeah, that was it. Since I don't think we have any more submissions, I think I'm just gonna say goodbye in here and end the stream. Yeah, thank you everybody for coming and sending in tracks. I'm sorry if there were tracks that I just couldn't go through, but it is what it is. Sorry. But yeah, goodbye everybody. Have a nice day.